This morning in Your Money, here's a question for you. If your phone rings just once and the caller hangs up, what do you do? If you say, call the number back, you may have just lost $20. Susan Hogan joins us this morning with more on what I'm talking about, but we might be missing an important call. We don't want to miss that.
Honestly, I know, but I will tell you this. Right. If it's that important, they'll call you back.
Call back, all right.
But the chances of you, if you were to call this number back, what's going to happen is this called, it's a one-ring scheme that we're hearing about. And this, honestly, it's happened to me. And it's a really crazy thing. So what happens is, it's only on your cell phone as well. So your cell phone rings, and you go to pick it up, and then it's hung up. So if you go to call the number back, because of course you think that you missed something, you're going to get charged $19.95.
Oh, geez.
I know. It's an international call fee that comes to find out when you get your bill that you're getting this. And when you call this back, a lot of people are put on hold. They'll hear music. They'll hear some sort of an advertisement, which extends that call even longer. Oh, so the chances of that $19.95 going up even more is bigger.
So what are some of the area codes we need to be on the lookout for when we see them, you know, pop up there on the screen?
Okay, well, as I told you, over the weekend, I got this phone call.
You got this.
Area code, it was 268 area code, and it was from Antigua. Thankfully, I knew not to go into it.
Right.
Another one, 809 Dominican Republic, 876 was Jamaica, 284 British Virgin Islands, and 473 Grenada.
Jeez.
And the thing too, if you're lucky enough, on my cell phone, when the call came through, Brendan, it actually said Antigua. I'm like, Antigua? I'm like, I don't know anybody from Antigua.
Right.
And then I remembered hearing about this one ring scheme, so I wanted to pass it along.
So many people have this tendency, they just want to answer. So, I mean,
yeah.
Who are these people? Like, what is going on here?
Well, according to the Better Business Bureau, this is a scheme that they're using. It's a practice called cramming, and they're usually third parties who literally infiltrate your cell phone data. So they will randomly call just numbers and, you know, hopefully to get a hit. And then what's happening, you know, as I said, they're putting you on hold or whatever. In this particular case, they're looking at it, they're thinking it's some sort of an adult entertainment service, but it's all used, it's an overseas service as well. So, and there's really no way for authorities to go and track these folks whatsoever.
Right.
It's now, really crazy.
Exactly. And none of us want to be, you know, a victim. So what can we do to protect ourselves from these fiends out there?
Okay, couple of things.
I need $20. I can't losing $20.
I can't either. Yeah. I'm right there with you. So a few things that you can do. First of all, check your phone bill. Every single statement that comes in, if you don't recognize any figure, whether it's $19.95, $9, and it looks like some sort of a weird number, call your carrier immediately and let them know that you don't recognize this number. Also, call your cell phone provider. A lot of times they will also block those third-party callers for you. And if you're really tempted to contact that number and call it back, Google that area code number plus the area code. Sometimes it will tell you what it is. It might say scam or scheme, so you know maybe to back off. Also, there is, this is really cool, there's a site called whocalledus.us.
All right.
And if there is some sort of a scheme out there, they are really good. They're right on top of it, and they'll let you know whether this particular area code or phone number that's calling you is legit or not.
Well, these are tremendous tips. We
Thanks.
Can't thank you enough. And that's,
sure.
this is, we're all communicating via cell phones these
no
days.
Kidding.
And this is, we have to protect ourselves.
Right.
And thankfully, you're here to be on the lookout. I got to tell you, Susan, I'm usually just so thrilled to be getting a call, but I just want to take it or I want to call back. So
okay, well, don't
do
okay,
it.
Okay, promise
it's,
you. No. Yeah.
All right. So if we've learned anything, it's don't. But we thank you so much for
sure,
joining us, Susan.
Brendan.
And if you missed any of these tips, you guys, do not worry. You can get them on our website. It's the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.